All right, 12 minutes after the hour, y'all, Ricky Smiley Morning Show. Y'all give it up, show your love right now. Welcome to the Ricky Smiley Morning Show. The one and only.
Yeah.
Why you playing the president?
Just to ease your mind, and then we'll reconnect you with what's really going on in a minute.
Y'all give it up for Joe Budden, y'all.
Thank you.
Not to ever be confused with Vice President Joe Biden.
That's right.
Always confused with Joe Biden.
Have you ever, like, you know, got booked to appear somewhere and then, like, you realize, like, yo, man, they probably
got picked up in a motorcade?
No, I'm not that important yet. Not yet. They don't get that confused.
Hey, man, welcome to the show, man. One more time for Joe Budden, y'all.
Oh!
Thank you, man.
Brand new album in stores as of yesterday, No Love Lost.
No Love Lost.
And one thing I admire about you, Joe, you have no problem laying it out on the line. Like, I mean, like, on every album, it seems like, you know, it plays out like a diary. You know what I'm saying? And, like, your storytelling ability really puts you in that room. You had a record on probably like 3 albums ago where you was talking about some girl you ran off with to Vegas, and I think she was cheating on somebody. She was cheating on a ball player or something like.
With me?
Man.
I remember that.
Like, dude has a way of putting you in the room. And these are all based off the true stories.
Yeah, definitely.
And she was cheating on the dude.
Yeah, with me. She was cheating on him with me. And I allowed that to happen.
Yeah. Wow. And so what did she say to the dude? How did she play the dude?
That's none of my business. I try to mind my business.
Wow.
I was younger. In my younger days.
Wow.
I'm more mature now.
So do you figure out a way to compartmentalize all the things that happened to you and you open that box up when it's time to write?
I mean, it's all just very honest to me. Like, all of it. So it's easy. Like, I started writing that way. So other people seem to be in awe at it. I guess honesty is not a trait that people just showcase very often.
Especially in rap, because most people lie.
Well, only rappers lie.
I'm going to step in and say that I have become a Joe Budden fan, especially on this season of Love and Hip Hop New York.
Thank you.
Little Junior Baby Crush. I'm just going to go on and tell you. And the fact that you keep it 100, you're open about, we see everything unfold. The drama between Tahiri and your present girlfriend. Are y'all still together?
Mm-hmm.
So you're still with your girlfriend?
Yes.
Okay, but there's this thing with you and Tahiri that just can't be denied.
Go away.
Well, I mean, catch me up, Evan. What happened?
How long have you were you and Tahiri together?
5 years.
5 years, and you, like, chronicled a lot of what you guys did because you put it online on the internet. She has a awesome body. I'll show you a picture of her. Her body's off the chain. So, who are you really in love with? Because
I'd like to think I'm in love with my girlfriend.
Okay, but you and Tahiri still.
All right, I'd like to think.
But you got to see what happens on the show.
I'd like to think so.
You and Tahiri meet at restaurants. Tear up restaurants and stuff like that. What is it?
Well, I'd like to have a platonic friendship with Tahiri.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not certain that that's possible.
Wow.
Yeah,
what?
Here's Tahiri.
You can't be with Tahiri by just one woman if you got a variety.
Okay, yeah, but so we
you think you'd like to be monogamous with Tahiri?
No. With my significant other, with my girlfriend.
That's which one is the new girlfriend?
No, Tahiri is the ex. This is new girlfriend.
This is Tahiri.
What I like about your new girlfriend is the fact that when you told her on the show, and you're open about the fact that you've had an ongoing struggle with drugs.
Oh,
the fact that she said that she's going to still be down with you, whatever.
Yeah, right. She got a ride. That is commendable.
And she doesn't care that you want to be friends with Tahiri? Like, if you was my dude, I wouldn't be... why are you so pressed about being friends with your
Now, which one with the big booty on the internet
That's
right
Tahiri,
here?
That's Tahiri, yo.
You lying to me, bro. You bro, you got on up out of that? Bro, you walked away from that?
Well, you got a new girlfriend.
Kaylin.
Okay, I ain't seen the new girlfriend, but this one right here.
I don't see the picture you looking at, so I can't...
No, the one from Bob.
Let me see what picture. Bob.
I mean, I don't think Tahiri's ever taken a bad picture. That computer's broken.
You're looking at a black screen.
So we're going to be talking more with...
I saw it. It was up there a minute ago.
Oh, yeah. That is one of the good pictures.
Bruh, you walked away from that. How you walked away from that?
These women...
That takes courage.
These women need to come with... Like, there needs to be a list of character defects when you meet them.
Right.
You see a whole bunch of these beautiful women that look that way, and then you meet them, and they be having stuff going on.
Awkward.
And
crazy.
Yeah.
Weird.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Stinking.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, y'all weird and crazy. We're going to talk about this when we come back. We're with Joe Budden. You can call him 1-8-6-9 Ricky. 1-8-6-6-9-R-I-C-K-E-Y.
I tell you what, both of y'all can kiss them.
Smiling Morning Show. Wake up.
Let go.
All right, Smiling Morning Show, bottom of the hour. Joe Budden's in the building. Hey, you want to give you want to give a shout out to any club?
we can shout out that club I was at last night. What's the name of that club?
Follies.
Follies.
How was the girls, man?
Last night. I want to shout out to them girls and their doctors who gave out them C-sections. I was thinking quite a few tips though for them. I wrote them all down.
They had full C sessions or bikini C sessions?
No, full.
So the incisions just what? Look, they didn't.
It was bad. Like maybe he had too much to drink.
Well, I've been there before. One of those chicks had a heart transplant.
Are you serious?
Yes, yeah, so that's what that middle scar was.
Are you serious?
Yeah, it was.
So which strip club got the Vietnam vets in that band? You know, with the tire tracks across the back and the baby daddy and that.
I don't see, normally I come out here and I maybe do a diamond or on and so or something like that. But I mean, last night it was late. I said, this is the only club closed at 3.
They put the B team back out. The A team went home. They put the junior varsity back out there.
Yeah, yeah.
What was the worst one you seen? Well, last time I got a lap dance, the chick was pregnant, her water broke. I said, what the hell?
Yeah, I done seen chicks with that have had big birth control patches on them.
No, they have not, Joe. Why they're dancing? Rainbows?
I can't make this stuff up.
You said, Ricky, you said you'd be feeling sorry for the ones that have on glasses.
Yeah, it'll always be the one with the thick glasses on sitting in the corner, look like she really don't want to be there. She just want to pay for her tuition. So I just give her $20 and say, keep your clothes on. Just God bless you and your family.
Now, we got Joe Budden in the studio. And when it comes to women, man, you are like the David Spade of rap. You have never been photographed with nothing less than a dime. And, you know, there's a lot of dudes out there who need... Yeah, well, I mean, some of them are even finer than that. But what I'm saying is there's a lot of dudes out there who want to know what your strategy is. Like, what are three tips you can give to people out there to, like, you know, really make that impact and get the lady that they want?
Ciroc.
So you don't have it?
No, I didn't know I had that reputation. I'm just honest.
That's part of it. I'm just going to tell you what the attraction factor is, I think, for most women. And you're weird.
And that.
Yeah.
I'm weird.
You are weird. You're very kind of, you say things, but you say it eloquently, and you're off, kind of. But that's the kind of stuff that makes us, weird. My grandma said,
y'all like that?
Yeah. He's unpredictable.
Like that, man. So what do you think your weirdest quirk is? Like the weirdest thing, like, you know, chicks, like, once they meet you, they find out, like, oh, man, he's into that.
You know what? I mean, the one that I can say that to my knowledge, I sit Indian style.
How's he doing? Ain't nothing wrong with that.
I'm telling you, it's odd.
People say it's weird.
Yeah, ain't nothing wrong with sitting Indian style.
Like Buddha, like you chant or something
like
that?
Yeah, and other people say it's weird that I can get up from that position not using my hands.
Oh, wow.
Did you practice?
It's like, that's not a problem.
See, I didn't know that was weird. It's just a long time ago.
Yeah, you're very odd.
I'm in vision.
Okay, let's go to the
album in stores now.
Shout out to Joe Budden. Definitely be sure you cop that, man. Digital and physical copy. And speaking of physical, man, the way you handled the situation with Consequence the other night, man, was very G and mafioso like, man.
Oh, thank you.
I appreciate your gangster.
Thank you.
Because you didn't know they were recording, did you?
No. I didn't know they were recording. He had done a couple of radio interviews. Where he was just saying, you know, he was saying a lot. And I was at the radio station in New York. Just so happens he was walking in right behind me. And
what?
He didn't know, look how God just put you right here.
There you go.
Yeah, God would do that. He didn't know.
That is.
When you can thug somebody down with just words alone, you know what I'm saying? It's an amazing thing.
Well, your fame is a drug. So people, you know, people get in front of that microphone, especially people that, you know, that the people may not want to hear from so often.
Right.
You know, they get in front of that microphone and just start saying whatever it is that fly out the mouth.
So the beef started with him getting fly when he was doing interviews.
I mean, yeah, I wouldn't call it beef, because I didn't want to hurt him.
Right.
Yeah, he was getting real fly.
Yeah.
And he had his lady with him. I mean, I just asked him if he had anything he needed to say to me that now would be probably a good opportunity for me to do that.
And he said.
And he just went into 5 minutes of rambling. It's all online. I swear I didn't know they were taping.
Yeah, he speaking in tones.
Yeah. But I mean, you know, it wasn't beef, because I told everybody in the room to have a nice day at the end of it. I wished everyone well.
Joe Buttons, how can he follow you online, Chief?
You can follow me on Twitter at Joe Buttons, BDDEN, Jesus, I sound like I'm doing this. The, my voice sounds like I'm doing
your
this.
Your voice Midnight sounds mad. Absolutely.
What's a Maxwell House coffee now?
What's going on out there? You trying to put some treble in.
Yeah, you fucking.
Yeah. Joe Budden, y'all.
JoeBuddenTV.com. No Love Lost in stores right now. I want to thank all of you for having me.
Thanks for coming, man. It's so polite, man.
We have to do this again sometime.